Hello, welcome back. In our last video, I had made a template and I had the fabric pieces placed on the template and I had tacked them together and I was going to machine stitch them. What I have today is the template removed with the fabric pieces sewn together. Now you might ask what reasons I tack and then machine stitch. And well, it's part of my process, I guess, coming from a sewing background. But I find that working with silks can be quite challenging. The fabrics tend to slip and slide. And I want quite a stable carry fabric to work with. The next part is the part that I actually enjoy the most, and that's playing around with the wool on top of the carry fabric. And I've chosen an assortment of colours. Now, they've all been dyed by the same person. Jacinta of Spiral Dyes. So even though the colours vary, they tend to be a bit similar because the base colours are similar. These are all Superfine Merino, as you can see in the assortment of colours. Over the next day or two, I'm going to be playing with the roving on top of the surface of the fabric. I hope you can stay with me. As you can see, I've just been playing around with the different colours. I think this one's too bright, but never know, it might just work. And this one, called a piece lazuli, I'm going to be working with on the black pieces, black areas. So I'm going to actually split this in two now. And I've also got this beautiful marine, it's called, and some of the same colour, but with the mulberry silk. I've been playing around with a few motifs. I've been particularly stuck on the idea of a leaf, but also of an eye within the leaf. And of these kind of wild flowers. But also, you know, a flower, but it could be a sun. So I've just been doodling. I've also worked out where the pattern's going to go. Like for instance, the flowers or the sun motif I have in mind to do on the black pieces of Georgette. So even though, you know, I've stitched all these pieces of fabrics together, I think it's a bit like working on several pieces of, several scarves, I guess, and try and marrying them with the colours as well as with the pattern. So as I start to play with the roving, I've got these motifs in mind. I don't intend to cover the entire fabric. I want as much carry fabric as exposed as possible. So we'll see if I'm able to concretize my drawings with the wool and the carry fabric. I like to split the roving lengthwise so that I can use, you know, the entire breadth of the colourway. I don't like to kind of use the middle part. I mean, I've chosen the colour for the entire length of the piece. And so I'm going to try and, you know, keep it as whole as possible. I split down lengthwise like so. Not always perfect. So I use about this much this much roving. This is as thick as I'll get it. For the eye motif, I'm going to be using a shishi roll. And if you don't know what a shishi roll is, I'll show you how to make one out of roving. Just roll it up. You can make these as thick and as long as you want. Can do is just cut it. So I've got my shishi rolls. I'm just going to shape an eye with this. Just playing with it. A bit too thick. I've had this roving for a while, so it's tended to felt itself. As you can see, I've got my centerpiece much more advanced in terms of laying out. I'm going great guns actually. I just wanted to show you a little bit of the detail. But first, just notice that I've actually covered up the seams with roving. I like to add these little details. This is just a piece of fabric scrap that I've pulled out of my drawer. And I've done it quite randomly. Just reached in and pulled it out. Got some others here. So I also play with these bits of fabric as well, just to add texture. And I guess just make the surface a bit more complex. As you can see, I've made a bit of progress. I've done the main panel and the two black georgette pieces. I'm going to be calling it quits for the day. It's over 30 degrees here today and I've been sweating like a pig all day. Hope you'll join me again tomorrow. Bye bye. I finished laying up, or laying out, and this is what I have.
Well, I've got these loose fibres, so I actually need to hold them down with just a little bit of wool. Because they might be resistant to felting.